when you dig deep enough to find enough alternative spellings of whatever you want, you'll always find something that's eventually good enough to make your experiment good. Yeah, it was true. It was true that if you dig deep enough, you'll always find some weird things. So now the question is our list a weird list that we struggle to make up, or is their list a weird list that they struggle to make up? It's a very subjective question. So here's what we said next. We said, you know what? Here's the way to settle the score. Let's together, there's a whole team of these guys who were against us, right? Let's independently hire a researcher. We'll give him the original list, the gist of the names. We'll ask him, what do you think are the most common ways of referring to these names? Whatever you say, that's what we'll plug in, we'll run the experiment. Not my researcher, not your researcher, we're going to hire a new third independent guy. If he says this is the way you spell the Vilna Gaon, that's the way we're going to look for it. He says this is the way you spell Rav Yosef Karo, whatever other name, the Marshal, whoever, that's the way we're going to look for it. We wanted to show that we didn't cheat that in this experiment. Right? They're claiming we cheated in this experiment. We want to exonerate ourselves on this experiment. So we said, let's hire a new researcher independently together. Whatever he says, we'll write it, we'll do it, we'll see what happens. He refused to do it. They didn't want to. They didn't say, no, we proved that you could have cheated. We don't have to go do anything else. We're not going to take it a step further. They published their paper in the same Journal of Statistical Science, claiming that, look, we did it in War and Peace, therefore they could have cheated. That's what came out. Because of that, and because of their refusal to rerun a new experiment that's objective, then we said, you know what, let's just do other experiments that totally avoid the whole problem of how you spell names. We looked for the names of all the Masechtas of Shas. There's no machlokas on how you spell the names of the Masechtas. Their whole claim of cheating is because there's so many ways of spelling names. They do the Masechtas of Shas, or you do the names of the Shvatim, or you do the names of the Shivimamim, or the cities that Yeshua was Kovesh when he came into Eretz Yisrael. Those are all Mefurish Psukim and Makoros, where there's no Machlokas anywhere on how you spell any of that information. It's a clear list. There's no room at all for any subjectivity or any human interference of what to look for, what not to look for, and how you spell it. And it's very clear and very straightforward. Those are the experiments that we found time after time after time after time came out to be very strong results. So what comes out La Maskana is that all the controls we did were War and Peace and nothing shows up. So what comes out basically is you'll find, if you do a Google for Bible codes or Torah codes, you'll find hundreds of websites literally that claim we proved codes aren't true. It's a hoax, it's been disproven, all scientists are against it. All they're ever referring to is the original experiment of rabbis' names. Nobody has found any way at all of refuting any of the other experiments. Nothing. So all the kashas were on that one experiment because of spelling. She said, fine, forget about spelling. We'll do new things altogether. We did it. It's come out glatt, and nobody's found any way of refuting it since. Most people don't know that. Most people think it was a whole controversy. They just proved it. The whole thing's out the window. That's where it stands, basically, scientifically. So one last thing I was going to say scientifically on the science end is there is a mathematician at Caltech named Barry Simon. Barry Simon is a frum senior mathematician at Caltech University. He is violently anti-codes. Violently anti-codes. His hanukkah is that there's no way Hashem would give scientific evidence that God wrote Torah, because then we don't have Bechira anymore. No, Bechira meaning it's such a proof that Torah is true, you don't have a choice. You have to believe in Torah. That's what he means. Not Nevuah. So he doesn't believe in the whole idea of proving Torah Misina. I agree. I think historical proof is extreme.
Does he feel the science is so strong that he has to make it?
No, so what he does, therefore, is he looks for ways mathematically, because he doesn't believe Hashem would encode Torah, so therefore he looks for ways mathematically to try and disprove it. His big thing you'll find on the web is a few years ago, he created a petition of 65 senior mathematicians from all around the world, all signing a petition saying codes is nonsense, it has no scientific validity. So hold on a second. So he said, the petition says it has no scientific validity, has no scientific merit. I was a little surprised that there are 65 mathematicians that looked into it and found problems with it, because I know that those problems don't really exist. I sent an email to 30 out of the 65 under a false name. I said, I'm a guy doing math studies. I heard about this thing with codes. I heard you're against it. Can you please tell me what your specific opposition is to codes and Torah? I've looked into it. I don't see any problems. What's your opposition? All 30 of them wrote back and said, we never really looked into it. Barry Simon is a friend of ours. He asked us to sign this petition. It's such a busha. Is it a sign to lending their name? I'm planning on doing something with it one day. Not yet in the meantime. Bottom line is, you'll find that all the people that are against codes all have a problem, besheetsa, with codes, even before you get into all the mathematical arguments. Most of them are chiloni, they're Israeli scientists who just hate the idea of Torah being true. So also, you'll have to try and find ways of disproving it. That's basically where it stands. So bottom line is, all the experiments we've done since the rabbi's experiment are so strong and are so unattackable, because it has nothing to do with spellings, there's no way, nobody's had any way of refuting anything that we've done. It stands scientifically very solid ground right now. Our stuff has been published in a number of different journals, and I make it very clear, they have not found any way of refuting it. They haven't refuted this stuff. All they're talking about is the rabbi's experiment. Harry Simon can go to town with this spelling and this name and that name, and he could have cheated in five different ways. Fine. But tell me what's wrong with the sectors of Shas and the 31 cities and the... Yeah. I did it very briefly because we were running late, but... Their whole attack is on the rabbi's names. Yeah, Barry Simon, that's his whole attack. So I'm telling Joe Schmo, this has been published and nobody's found any way of refuting it. Period. It's been published, it's out there. So I'm making a very specific statement. We've published this stuff, it's been out there for years, and nobody anywhere has found any way of refuting it. All the attacks are on something we did 15 years ago, where there's all shiva on spelling and economic, but it has nothing to do with anything we've done in the last 10 years.